If you're like me, you probably think you know what simplicity means, right? I mean, that's a word we use all the time. But I would be willing to bet that, like me, a lot of what you think you know about simplicity is actually wrong. Hi, I'm Amber, and today I want to talk to you about 12 myths about simplicity. We're going to dispel some common misconceptions and help you understand that simplicity is a lot closer than you think. If you're new here, be sure and subscribe to this channel, ring that bell so you get notified every time I make a new video, and if this video helps you, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. Myth number one is that simplicity is unattainable. That it's a nice concept, it sounds good in theory, but it's just not reality. Obviously, this is false. Any of us, no matter where we're starting from, can get more simplicity. Simplicity is a mindset and a way of handling our lives. It's a strategy for dealing with all we have to do, and it's something that any of us can work towards, no matter where we're beginning. All we need to do is set our sights on it, and every day take small incremental steps to get more simplicity in our lives. Myth number two is that it takes a long time to get simplicity. Now, hopefully you've already checked out my definition of simplicity. I'll put a link to that video up above. But ultimately, I see simplicity as a mindset and a methodology, in which case we don't have to wait. And it's not something that takes forever. We can actually have simplicity immediately, right now, just by shifting our perspective and working to protect our time, be more productive, be more efficient, and align our time with our priorities. Obviously, big changes rarely happen overnight. We're all, myself included, big works in progress. But it's again about deciding that we want a simpler life and then working to get more simplicity day after day. The third myth of simplicity, and this is probably the biggest one, is that simplicity is an end point, that it is something that we get or we achieve and then we're good to go. The reality is that simplicity is a journey, not a destination. It's so much better viewed as a spectrum, a continuum, if you will, where we have complexity and chaos on one side, followed by simplicity and joy on the other. And no matter where we are on this line, the ends stretch out infinitely, so we can always move more towards a simpler way of life. Conversely, there are obviously things that happen or things we do that make our life more complex. So wherever you're starting from, again, simplicity is in reach. It's important to recognize that no matter how far we get towards simplicity, we might fall. We might revert back to our old habits. We might come across something or have something happen to us that sets us back. That's going to happen. It's normal. It's going to occur. But again, simplicity is about how we handle those moments, what we do in the face of adversity. And we can still have an inner peace and contentment no matter our crazy external circumstances. Myth number four is that simplicity is easy. How often do we interchange those words? Simple, easy, right? They actually don't mean the same thing. And the very hard truth is that simplicity is often anything but easy. It's really, really hard to consciously, intentionally think about our choices and our actions and work to get simplicity in our life. But the work is so worth it. Another thing that makes simplicity so hard is that our natural human tendency is to say yes to everything, right? To constantly be scooping up all the opportunities and the moments we can, but that tends to lead us into stress and anxiety and frustration because we end up with more to do than time to do it. So cutting back, clearing our plate, simplifying our tasks is definitely easier said than done. The good news is that it's possible, and again, as you'll hear me say over and over, there are scientifically proven ways to do this. Myth number 5 is that simplicity just comes more naturally to some people than others. Now, this is actually an area that I've researched extensively because I know that we all have different personality traits and that personality can have an impact on our behavior and our decisions. But I've also confirmed that our innate traits do not predetermine where we end up. Each of us, no matter our starting personality, can work towards more simplicity. It's also really essential to remember that even if something looks simple for someone else, chances are that's not how they're perceiving it. Everyone has their struggles and their challenges, and we have that grass is greener mentality that isn't necessarily reality. Simplicity isn't about anyone else. It's about us. It's about what we are doing, what we are thinking, the steps we are taking to have more joy and more time in our life. Anyone who knows me would be the first to tell you that my standard way of doing things is anything but simple. And so if I can do it, I promise you, you can too. Myth number 6 is that it's too late for me to get simplicity, that I'm somehow in a situation where I've missed the boat. Simplicity would be nice, but it's just not in the cards. Obviously, that is false. It's never too late. Every moment is a chance to start over, to start anew, and recognize that whatever we were doing, whatever we used to believe, doesn't have to be what we continue to believe. Myth number 7 is one I am so guilty of. It's the myth that simplicity is incompatible with our current circumstances. Maybe you've got 3, 4, 5 kids. Maybe you're working 80 hours a week. Maybe you're caring for sick parents. Maybe you're traveling a lot. Maybe you've been really, really sick. Whatever your external situation might be, remember that simplicity is possible because it's a mindset. We don't need to be held back. And in fact, if we feel overwhelmed by our circumstances, chances are that simplicity is exactly the remedy that we need. When we're in a tough season, it's so easy to feel stuck and hopeless. But we have to remember that that's our perception. It's not reality. And the more that we can recognize how we're feeling, but push ourselves to move past it, the faster, easier, and better we will get to a simpler life. The 8th myth is that it takes a lot of money to have the luxury of simplicity. The truth is that simplicity is whatever we define it to be. Simplicity is not about money. It's an internal sense of peace and contentment, and we can have that whether we have money or not. Conversely, myth number 9 is that simplicity is somehow incompatible with wealth, that if you really want to live a simple life, you shouldn't have money. The truth is, again, that simplicity is not related to money. Just as simplicity doesn't require money, neither does simplicity require poverty. Money is not inherently evil. We can actually do a lot of good with it. The important thing is to remember that something's true worth is independent of its monetary value. We are not the sum of money that we make or the amount of things that we produce. We are worthy just as we are. The ultimate point is that simplicity is not tied to our financial status. Myth number 10 is that simplicity is boring. Why would we want that, right? The truth is that simplicity is just the opposite. The whole point of simplicity is freeing up our time so that we can actually do more of what we love and we're not burdened by things that aren't what we want to be doing. Simplicity is about shedding whatever isn't serving us so that we have time and energy for the things that do bring us value and joy. The other component here is that simplicity, at least in my experience of this journey, is quite a wild ride. We might take one step forward and 2 steps back, or think that we're making such progress and then something happens and we're back at square one. The point is just to keep trying. It's not boring, and it's really all the more exciting as it becomes second nature. Myth number 11 is that simplicity is incompatible with technology. We are fortunate to live in a day and age where things are easier than ever because we have technology that helps us be more productive and saves us time. In that sense, then, technology can actually be really helpful for simplicity. But as we all know, it's also a double-edged sword. We have to be careful that technology doesn't become a temptation, a distraction, something that takes us away from the things that we really value. All right, the final myth, myth number 12, is that simplicity is old-fashioned, that it was something you could have back in the day, maybe some different historical period, but it's not applicable to our busy modern life. The truth is that simplicity is needed now more than ever. Each of us can decide here and now that we want a simpler, more joyful life. All right, so now that we've finally gotten through all 12 of those myths, let me know in the comments below if any of them were myths that you used to hold. And hopefully you've been convinced that no matter what prior beliefs about simplicity you had, simplicity really is possible and it's something you can start working towards today. Thank you so much for watching. Again, don't forget to like this video if it helped you. Share it with someone who might need to hear its message. If you're interested in more resources, you can always check out my website, solutionsforsimplicity.com. I'll put a link in the description below. And then don't forget to follow me on Instagram and subscribe to this channel so that you get the latest news on all of the different discoveries and strategies and tips, tools, tricks I've found for prioritization, productivity, time management, and that elusive thing we call work-life balance. Thank you, have a great day, and until next time, I'm glad you're joining me for the journey.